What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. What's good? So today, y'all know I'm always watching some quirky short movie, and I always come tell y'all about the movie, right? This one is called. No copyright strike, fix it, Jesus. Okay. Oh, this movie is 9 minutes. Eight. Oh. Listen, I hope them couple of seconds don't get me in trouble. But it's called 1500. And the man is married. He is down to his last 1500 words before he died. And I'm like, really? What kind of world do he live in? Because they give you no background, y'all. Like, you don't know how this world... Because it looks like regular Earth. It's not aliens or anything creepy. It's just a regular neighborhood, possibly Britain, the UK or something with that accent. Did I say Britain? Not Britain. Well, whatever. And he's in the doctor's office, and the doctor is going over, you know, hey, you know, you down to your 1500 words. And I'm like, wow, what if we were born with a set of words? Like, you don't know the number you have left until it's close, you know, y'all. So the doctor sit him down and was like, hey, you know, you got 1500 words left until you die. And I guess they know this is coming, but because it's still hard to accept, like anything, when you get told bad news, that you're basically going to die soon or however long till you run out of your words, you're in denial. And he in the office, he like, fuck, you know, he cussing, knocking stuff over. And the guy like, click, 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 sucking all his words down, y'all. And finally, after he cussed, you know, he sit down and it sink in like, it sink in at 100. And when he handed it to him, he was like, here's your, I guess you get this clicker. And it, every time you speak, it starts counting it down. And he was like, so you got this many words, we're going to compose this letter or whatever it was. I can't remember. And so when he get ready to go, he say something and he cuss. He like, fuck, under his breath. He was like, 44. He like, damn. He say something else. He like, 43. So he get out of the doctor's office. He walking home and he's really trying to figure out, well, how do I tell my wife? So you don't get much background about him and his wife. You do see that it's like a marriage that's kind of on the rocks. You don't know if perhaps he's unemployed and she's been pulling the weight. Have their marriage just been falling apart? Did he cheat? You don't know, but you can tell things aren't quite as good, but not as bad. So he tries to figure out little stuff to communicate, but not communicate. And I guess before he got notice of his 15 words, he had been trying to make his relationship, his marriage better. So now he's down to 1500 words. It's like, I can't even talk. So what he did was at some point, y'all, he started saying one words to express a moment, like supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. Okay. I'm just making that up. I know that is a word of some sort. I said it all wrong, but it would be a word like that. That would mean like I'm happy or something like that. And the wife like, you know, looking at him all crazy. And after a while, she get tired of that. She like, you know, they go to bed. I don't think, or they don't imply that they had sex. Because I'm like, you talk during sex. I would have been dead in the first 30 seconds. So, you know, choke me, beat me, daddy. I don't know. I'm just kidding. because they were in bed. And so she says the ultimate what every husband or nobody want nobody to say. We need to talk. And then I don't know if they spoke. It don't show that they spoke. It just show her saying we need to talk, his face, and then the front door opening, him walking out, and she slamming the door. So perhaps they didn't talk. So he go to the woods with beer, get drunk. What do most people do when they get drunk and they're upset? Cuss and talk. Girl, sorry, fellas, because I'm always talking to my girls. He wake up from a drunken stupor with one word left. He looked at his hand. It was one word left, y'all, because he had got drunk and cussed out everything in the woods and was calling a duck all night, Catherine. I think his wife's name was Catherine. And he's thinking to himself, really. So they give you a telephone number that you can call, I guess, to set up your last goodbyes or whatever. But I'm thinking the number is for you before you get down to one literal word, because it's a phone automated thing. So she's like, hi, how many words do you have left? And, you know, if you got 100, 1500, 3. When he put in 1, I think it says, sorry to hear that. So it's asking him, well, spell your wife's name. And so, you know, when you remember old school phones, you got to double tap each number to get to the letter. So it was saying the wife's name wrong. He was getting irritated, but he's still being quiet because he's down to one word. And I guess it was supposed to try to figure out an adjective or whatever to leave a message. So the girl, he pulled out his wallet. So while it's asking him, okay, because when it was repeating the wife's name wrong, he just pulled out his wallet and you see him, he looking. And it's kind of flashing back. You see the wife smiling and, you know, like these memories going before him. And it's like, hello, the operator. It's automated too. So you know how automated stuff irritates you anyway when you get it wrong. We're sorry. You're going to have to. She was like, do you want to keep the call? Like, do you want to hold on? Because the, you know, push 3 to hold on. And I think she said it on her, like, her 5th time. He was like, yes! As soon as he said it, he went, and then it go off, the words pop up, and literally you hear his body collapse. Oh, yeah. So, I'm going to link it. Be sure you watch it. Watch it. Come back and talk to me about it. Give me your thoughts about it. I'm going to give you mine really quickly. One that really made me think about the importance of using my words and trying to make any time I talk to anyone, depending on who, because if I talk to a total stranger, it's, you know, good morning, hi, hello, good evening, how are you, you know. But when you come down to your loved ones, your friends, if you had a set of words, like if you didn't know how many words you had, would you change how you handle conversations? Would you change how you talk to people, period? Because every word counts. So just, you got to go to work, say good morning. You got to be courteous. Your job could be customer service. And see, this is all speculation because it doesn't tell you what is going on in the world. You don't know, either they take away customer service jobs. Obviously, they have conversations. You're talking to people. So I don't know. But I was like, wow, you know, if all I had was 1,500 words left, who and what would I talk to? Obviously, my children. Obviously, my family. But what would you say to maybe a friendship loss? What would you say to perhaps a child or a family member you're not cool with, but you want to make things right, or maybe you don't want to make things right? Maybe it's someone's doing good at their job and you just didn't get a chance to really support them like you want to. What if, it's just 1,500 words left. What could you say to survive? Because that, if you can keep those 1,500 words, you don't know if you live forever or if you're going to, I guess if you get hit by a car or something tragic, you're going to die. But I wish those little short films just kind of leave you stumped with the speculation. So 1,500 words, I would hope that before I would get to 1,500 words that I wouldn't have to break my neck to say the right things or to fix anything. So I could just, you know, go home and say, hey, y'all, I'm down to my 1,500 words. I want to limit my conversation, but y'all know I love y'all. Like, get out 300 words or something, you know, or and have 1,200, like, let's talk, you know, blah, blah, blah. And then, and I don't, 300 words, that's like a tweet. I would go get a Twitter. Just say it. Oh my God, 1,500 words left. So tell me what your thoughts. Do you feel like conversations would be more meaningful? Would you be more mindful of the things you say, how you treat people? Would you learn how to text better? Would you learn how to text back? Because I'm assuming they had cell phones and you could text. I'm assuming, but then I didn't see no cell phones. Like, I never saw, you didn't see nobody like walking around with a phone. It was a payphone too, because he called on a payphone. So maybe the world that they're in, they don't have payphones, because that would really cheat death. You could text. You would never say nothing if it, when you got down to your last word. So I don't know. Give me your thoughts. I thought that was a really good movie. Short movie. The channel is called Amuleto. And that channel has a lot of good short movies. It is spelt O-M-E-L-E-T-O. And you want to search A Man with 1,500 Words Left to Live. That should pull it right up, but I'm also going to link it, so you can just click it in my description box and or in my comments. I just found that to be so crazy. Like, damn, 1,500 words. And I'm thinking, you know, watching, I'm like, well, have I said enough today? Have I said too little? But yeah, that was good. So that's it for that little conversation. Give me your thoughts below. What do you think? And if you're new to my channel, hit the subscribe button. Kick it with your girl. My channel, it's pretty cool. You'll like it over here. If you were OG and you've been around from the beginning, like, you the real MVP, and I love you. I love all y'all. Thank y'all for sticking around. So, all right, I'll be back with another video.